On Friday, 11th of August, Rhodes University will once again host the annual silent protest. The 2017 edition will, in consultation with students, have changes to the day-long program. The program will be shorter but more inclusive. Dr. Lindsay Kelland is the head of the organizing committee.
So we have changed a bunch of things in line with the student feedback. I think the most important change this year that's definitely affecting the program is that it's no longer a Rhodes event. It's called the Grahamstown Silent Protest, and it takes place as part of a kind of smaller national movement. So the protest is shortened, it's now half the day. So the kind of briefing, the morning part of the protest that culminates in the march to main admin is the same. But then the die-in, which, yeah, it does happen at lunchtime, will happen in front of main admin at lunchtime, and then straight from the die-in we'll go into a kind of debriefing, breaking the silence.
Dr. Kelland hopes that the silent protest will appeal to a larger community of people and have a bigger impact.
So one of the problems that people who work in this area, particularly academics, I think, who spend their lives, you know, kind of giving lectures and talks and seminars, is that we end up preaching to the converted. So I'm not sure if you came to any of the We Believe You campaign events last year. The audience is the same people, right, who would enroll in, say, a gender studies program. So you're not actually having a kind of impact outside of the space that you're already in, right? So, I mean, at those kinds of things, we had GAP and the members of Nkolifasi, the previous Outroads, right? So it's people who are already engaged in thinking about these issues that will voluntarily in the evenings come to a talk. On rape, on violent masculinities, on these kinds of issues. And what we need is obviously to be reaching the people who aren't already woke.
When asked about the amount of rape statistics at Rhodes University since the ARRI reference list, Dr. Kelland had this to say.
So the institution refuses to ever kind of release those statistics. So I don't know what the actual numbers are. No one does, except I'm guessing Nomangwane and maybe someone in the Division of Student Affairs. But if I were to imagine, I would imagine that they've stayed exactly the same.
The Grahamstown silent protest will for the first time include organizations such as Raphael Center, St. Mary's DCC, where people can go sign up for participation. The program is working in partnership with Higher Education Aids, and it will commence from 6 a.m. at Alec Mullins. This is Naledi Masango reporting for Oppi TV News.